Hey everybody, it's PartyElite, and you know me from my own YouTube channel where I cover strategy games similar to Victoria 3 extensively. Today I'm collaborating with Paradox Interactive to introduce you to a major driving force of your societies in Victoria 3. Interest groups. We'll discuss what they are, their traits and happiness, and the importance of clout. Interest groups represent the political power that your people hold when they work towards a common goal amongst themselves. Ops pick which interest groups to join based on their profession, wealth, and education access, as long as they're not discriminated against in some way, and as long as they're not too illiterate or too poor to be politically active. As groups of POPs that have similar social, political, and economic interests as far as policymaking and ideologies are concerned, they represent the voice of the people, encouraging or discouraging social and political change as best suits their needs. Their demands can come about in both peaceful and violent ways, and so you'll want to influence which interest groups wield the most power in your nation to help control how your society develops. It's important to note that though there are interest groups with the same names spread throughout the world, they are sometimes represented with unique names to represent a minor difference between two otherwise similar interest groups. The Sikh priesthood, for example, has Sikh militancy as an ideology, not something you're likely to find among the Mahayana monks, who are decidedly not Sikh. In addition to that, even interest groups with the exact same name across national borders will be somewhat different at times. Apart from three core ideologies, the current leader of the interest group will add a fourth ideology based on their personal leanings, unless they're a moderate, in which case they do not add a fourth ideology. Whatever they may call themselves though, interest groups always serve the same overarching purpose, have the same moving parts, and work in similar ways. To see which interest groups exist in your nation, you can use the outliner, breaking them down into interest groups and marginalized groups, where the latter refers to interest groups that lack any real political power in the form of clout. Each interest group has a certain amount of clout, an approval level, ideologies, traits, and a leader. Ideologies, as discussed previously, come as three core aspects plus one from the current interest group's leader, and they represent which laws an interest group opposes, endorses, or is ambivalent about. Interest groups will often push for policy changes that match these ideologies or push against reforms they oppose even after they've been passed. This can cause social and political friction that can eventually result in civil war if left unchecked. Their opinions about currently active laws and policies are a major contributor to their current approval levels, alongside recent law changes, whether they're in the government or in the opposition, how powerful they are, leader traits, and radicalization of the POPs in the interest group. Their approval levels, meanwhile, influence which of the three traits are actively having an impact on your nation. A malus from an approval rating at or below -5, a small bonus from an approval rating above 5, and an additional bonus from an approval rating above 10. Again, these are largely consistent between the same interest groups across nations. The positive and negative impacts from active traits are further affected by the interest group in question's clout. This is a measure of the interest group's political strength as a percentage of the total political strength of your POPs across all interest groups, whether they're marginalized or not. Political strength is generated through votes in an election where applicable, though it's primarily generated through politically active POPs and their collective wealth, though POPs have less than expected political strength in unincorporated states and more than the expected in the capital state. This means, then, that the number of POPs in an interest group, their wealth levels, and their location all play a role in how much clout an interest group has, which in turn determines whether they are powerful, with clout over 20%, influential, with clout below 20%, or marginalized, with clout below 5%. Clout also directly impacts how likely a policy change is to happen, as the sum of the clout of interest groups that support the change represents the percentage chance of the change going through each cycle. But that's a conversation for later. It's important to keep in mind, though, that if you do want to push for a policy change, at least one of the interest groups that endorses it needs to be in your government. If they aren't, you'll need to reform your government to include them, sometimes at the cost of your government's legitimacy, a measure of how your current policies match up with the interest groups that are in the government. You cannot bring marginalized groups into the government, though, so you'll have to improve their clout before you can do so. So, to empower an interest group and to enable their ideologies and preferred laws to flourish in your nation, you need to improve their clout. The key ways to do so are to enrich the pops in said interest groups and by influencing which interest groups your pops join as best as possible. We discussed how to influence pop wealth through income and expenses in the last two videos, but to influence which interest groups they join, you'll need to consider the attraction modifiers outlined when hovering over the interest group population. You need to try to align as many pops as you can to be attracted to the interest groups you want to empower. Encourage pops to change professions to those that gravitate towards your preferred interest groups. Enable or prevent their increased literacy. Research or avoid relevant technologies, and use your authority to bolster or suppress interest groups that you wish to grow or shrink, respectively. Interest groups have a very powerful influence on the stability of your nation and the direction in which it evolves over time through policy changes and lawmaking. If you're interested in learning more about that, make sure to subscribe to this channel and get notified when the next video releases, focused on policies and laws.